Hello friends, welcome back in once again, and today lecture we will discuss about WebView. Then first of all we will create a new project. Click on the Xcode and here click on the create new Xcode project, and here we will select app in iOS, and here click on the next, and here we will type name of the project WebView demo. We can take any name here. We can select the language of the project. Here we select already selected Swift, so core data we will not use here. Then we deselect it and click on the next, and here we create a new Xcode project. So in today lecture we will implement WebView in both way, from the code and from the storyboard. So first of all we click on the documentation. Here the Apple documentation is available. We can check in the Apple documentation. We use WKWebView class for implementing WebView in our application. In object that display interactive web content such as foreign in app browser. Then with the help of the WKWebView class we can display interactive web content in our application like web browser. Here is the class of the WKWebView, where WKWebView is subclass of the UIView, and here is the complete doc we can read out here. In WebView, object is a platform native view that you use to incorporate web content seamlessly into your app UI. So you can read here, all documentation is available. So we will discuss how we implement it. Then here is also given the code for WebView, how we can implement in our application. So first of all we import WebKit framework. So like this we will implement in our application. So first of all we click on the view controller. So here we import WebKit framework, and if you use any method then you can also add web delegate here. After importing WebKit we can add here WKUI delegate. We can add here, and after it we declare here the WebView. Suppose so here we add WKWebView class, and here we take the object of the WKWebView object. We can declare like this also. We add WebView on the UI view. Already given the code for it also. So we can copy it, or you can type it like this. WebView is equal to WKWebView. So here we type frame, and here we will add React. So we can add it 0. And next we add self.view. Dot add subview, and here we add WebView on the UI view. And if you want any content then we will take the URL string, so we can just copy it and edit. I have just take the string, a URL string I have taken here, and my URL. So here we will take the URL request, and here I just copy and paste the request. So now WKUI delegate we are not using, so if we did not take it then I think without it we can use the WebView. So now we run it. So anything is not displaying on the UI view, anything something is wrong, so we will check it. So I think here we have taken 0. So here we add the UI view frame dot view dot frame, and in last we add after this, and now I run again. So here is also data not displaying yet. So finally here data is displaying like web browser, So in our application we can implement it like this with the code. Then first we will add here UI view frame, and then we add web view on the UI view, and after it we create a URL and load URL request on the web view. So we can check here. So now we will add web view with the help of the storyboard. So click on the storyboard, and here we can add web view. Click on the library. So here we add web view. So one web view here is showing is deprecated. We will add webkit view. So here we will click on the webkit UI view, or we can drag it like this, and here we can add constant 0, 0, 0 and 0. UIKit WebView is added, and now we create the outlet of it. So click on the editor, and here we select the class. So UIView controller, and here click on the WebKit UIView, and here click on the outlet of it. So here we drag it and create the outlet with name WebKit view, connect it, and now we close it. So here now if I comment it and comment this code also, and here we add the request on. So I comment it, and we will use WebKit UI view. So we will copy it and paste. Now we run it. So we can check in the same way like with the code or with the storyboard. Then here we can check all the our link data is available on the application. So like this we can add WebView in our application, in our existing project, or we can create with the help of the a new application. Thanks for the watching.